Associating maps and blocks with information types in FS Pro 2020 is very easy. Now the first thing you need to do is check the outline pane if one of your maps or blocks is already associated with an information type. This is not the case. My map and my four blocks are all undefined. And you can check that by looking at the icon on the left of map 1 or block 1, 2, 3 or 4. Now, for example, if I want to change block 1 to one of the six information types, I simply select block 1, I right-click, and now I can easily select an information type, for example, a principal. And the icon changes, block 1 is now a principal. Same goes for maps, I select map 1, right-click, and I can select my information type, for example, process. Map 1 is now a process. Now, if I want to insert a block or a map associated with an information type right away, I can simply put my cursor, for example, after block 4. I go to the ribbon in FS Pro 2020, and I want to insert a fact, for example. I select the drop-down menu, effect, I select block, and a new block is added, and if you check the outline pane, the icon is changed, it is effect. So block 5 is a effect. Same goes for maps. If I want to insert a new map and I want that new map to be associated with a certain information type, I simply go to, for example, procedure, select the drop down menu of procedure, select map, and a new map is inserted, and if you check the outline pane, you can see that left of map title, you can see the icon of procedure. And that's how you associate maps and blocks with information types in FS Pro 2020.